Hi, this is Tom Salemi. You are here at the inaugural Aesthetics Innovation Summit, and I'm very happy to be joined by Steve MacMillan.
Thank you, Tom.
Chairman, President, and CEO, I want to get all three, of Hologic. Thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, I gave a great presentation in there, and we've talked to a lot of investors today, a lot of startup executives, and it's great to have you here as well, because you're representing, I think, a new player in aesthetics, and I'm hoping perhaps an influential acquirer going forward, which I think is something that I'm hearing the sector needs. Let's talk a bit about Hologic's move with the Cynosure acquisition. What does that mean for Hologic?
Sure, you hit it exactly right, which is, you know, coming from a long history in women's health between, you know, especially our breast health business, our molecular diagnostics, our pap testing business, our surgical business, we've been in and around and affecting women's health for 30 years. One of the very next obvious areas for us to continue our growth was to get into medical aesthetics. And to your question and point, we saw it exactly as an opportunity to come in, innovate, bring clinical differentiation, customer support, and also as the industry continues to consolidate, we picture being a consolidator in the space.
Well, that's what's been fascinating about Hologic through the years. I mean, it's always brought a buzz for some reason. When it was a small, mid-sized acquirer, people were waiting for you to grow to be a big acquirer. Then you acquired SciTech, and we're going to see what happens with women's health, and we saw what happened there. Now with aesthetics, what is it about Hologic that kind of brings that, I don't know, that guerrilla force to it?
Yeah, I think there's a special spirit inside the company, mm-hmm. and it probably starts with our roots, particularly in breast health, where, frankly, our employees have a mission. We care so much about the business. As you may have heard inside, my own mother was a breast cancer survivor. She was detected early. It's amazing how many of our own employees, even actually a woman that works for another company, came up to me after my presentation, gave me her card, said, Novosure, a Novosure procedure changed her life. She works for another company in there. She was immediately telling me, if you ever need a patient testimonial. And so there's this magic within our company. We've changed so many lives, and we really view the aesthetic side as an area to continue that in so many areas.
I was going to ask, how does Cynosure fit, how does its culture fit into Hologic's culture? Is there comparable attitudes towards, as you noted, clinical data and making sure that whatever you're selling, you have evidence it does what it says it should do?
Yes, what we really liked about Cynosure particularly is a lot of clinical expertise inside the organization. I remember when we were doing our due diligence, meeting the clinical team was actually very much a special part of the team. And we saw there was a strong history there, frankly, one that we think we can even build on going forward, particularly as we start to go more into the women's health area. Mm-hmm. As you hear Leah Millhiser from Stanford talking inside, especially gynecologists, OB-GYNs, they are more data-driven, they want more data. We think we can bring that. We think the industry is exactly at that point in time of, frankly, wanting and demanding more and better clinical data, and it fits perfectly with our mission.
Well, you were in Stryker prior to joining Hologic in 2013. What was the move like from Stryker, a more traditional med tech company, into a company that was primarily women's health? How large of a transition was that?
It's a big transition, certainly from traditional medical devices, but the fascinating part for me is, particularly with Hologic, where we're in the, for large cases, in the early diagnosis and early treatment of breast cancer, cervical cancer, we're helping to save money for the healthcare system. And that's been part of the magic, certainly. If you detect breast cancer and cervical cancer earlier, it's a huge impact on the people's lives, and frankly, it saves the healthcare system money. So that, you know, just was a great mission. But then, particularly as you start to look at the women's health area, women's health has really been underserved. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what, as we've brought Cheryl Crow in and Aaron Andrews and some of these people to really help get the messaging out. And that's where, particularly as we even go into, you know, particularly genitourinary symptoms of menopause and starting to think about stress urinary incontinence and other areas for the future, these have been areas that have really been taboo and just kind of pushed down and not talked about. And I think for me especially, it's just fascinating to see how much opportunity there is for both product innovation, but also patient and physician education mm-hmm. in the area. So it's just a fascinating, you know, area for us.
And we talked about the product synergy with the Cynosure acquisition. As CEO, what is the, and we did upon a bit, but what's the cultural synergy like, and how do you Is there a gap that you need to bridge to bring these two entities together into one cohesive unit?
Sure, there are gaps. I think we think the medical aesthetics industry is going through a bit of a shift anyway, in terms of from just, say, the old laser salesman, kind of the pejorative treatment of that, to much more of a recurring revenue, a customer service model. And Cynosure was just starting to go through that. I think we're accelerating that transition to, I think, a future that frankly is going to have much deeper relationships with our customers. And so the commercial side has probably been a little bit of a, an acceleration of that change. The inside of the organization, the R&D, I think what's been fascinating to watch the R&D team, typically when a big company takes over a small company, the R&D team gets concerned. Mm-hmm. In this case, I think they've actually been craving more of our involvement, mm-hmm. and they see what we bring to the party in terms of the clinical expertise, even some of the technologies. So, we have a much richer history in RF technologies, radio frequency. That's where some of the technology developments within Cynosure were about to go. So it's actually been one of those true areas of 1+1=2.
Interesting. And what about externally looking at R&D? What do you think your BD group will look like, if you'll even have one? Will you be out scouting, looking for startups? Will you be just opportunistic when they come to you? What can we expect to see?
Sure,
we
have a very active business development. That was a key part of what we expected to do in the space once we got in, because we see it's still a very fragmented industry with lots of opportunities. We're both out prospecting. Candidly, it's one of the reasons we came here, is to still introduce ourselves. We realize there's still not everybody in the industry quite knows what to make of Hologic, and this event was certainly a great opportunity for us to a little more showcase the history where we're going, and our teams have been out very busily meeting. We would certainly hope to be an acquirer, particularly of earlier or later stage technologies that we can put through our commercial organization.
Will you make direct investments?
We will always consider anything. It's traditionally not been a big area for us. Mm-hmm. I think in this space we are thinking about it.
And just final question, you referenced how you were really reaching out to patients in women's health to let them know where they could find a 3D mammogram, to really try to get them to be part of that process. Is that something that bringing an aesthetics company in helps reinforce, because we're seeing how powerful the patients are in aesthetics?
We think the whole patient dynamic, patient awareness, patient education, is just a huge driver, both of healthcare generally, particularly in this space. And we do think that a lot of what we've been doing on our other products is totally applicable here.
Excellent. Well, we're really grateful to have you come by.
Great. Thank you, Tom. Appreciate it.